Hello boys and girls, Mike here, One Go Short Play. Today we're doing a challenge, first little challenge. I met a few people in the retro community on YouTube recently, and I was just going along doing my own thing, trying to play everything on everything, and of course that takes a while, so I thought I wanted to do something a bit different. Today I am taking up the challenge from Martin at the Dusty Gamepad. He had to go with DJ Boy. I'm not sure I'm better at it than him. I'm pretty sure I'm not, but I did play this in the early 90s. My mate Steve, who was pretty much my Mega Drive buddy, had this game. Let me just pause it, turn down the volume a bit. I'm not sure if the game will talk over me, so I'm going to take that chance. But well, I'm not going to take that chance. I'm turning the volume down. Okay, let's have a go and see how we do. Okay. Getting used to the controls again. Now, I did play this back in the early 90s, as I say. A lot of potent memories around gaming, and particularly this game. Has that got stuff in it? I can't remember. You know what? I think I'm just going to avoid the cones, because, let's face it, they just give you a kicking, more so than the baddies do. Oi! Where's my jump button? There it is. Okay. It's going to be one of three, isn't it? The jump button. Jump kick punch. Okay, we've got it. Now, I didn't like this game, I have to admit. Back in the day, I thought it was sort of stringy to play. The whole roller boots thing didn't really work for me. Also, it's that kind of weird arcade pseudo fashion. Martin mentioned Skate out of Streets of Rage, and I totally see the resemblance, but I think that was more about trying to be down with the kids and kind of failing. No one really in the 90s dressed like this except the kids in Sega adverts. I mean, don't get me wrong, hats off to Sega, they did bring games to the kind of teenage market really, really well. But this was a bit, this sort of fashion statement was a bit misguided. It was up there with Def Leppard's Let's Get Rocked video, you know. caps and skateboards and stuff. And, you know, Bart Simpson, hyper Bart Simpsons. Just, kids weren't really like that. Then again, the kids I knew were a bit more kerkening than this. I wasn't at all. I was a bit more 80s rock, ripped jeans and long hair. But that was just me. Totally out of my time. Oh, what's the first level boss already? How did that happen? Now, I'm pretty sure I'm going to take a kicking off it, because I always did. As I said, I didn't really like this game. I was a Streets of Rage kid. As anyone with any sense would be. Now it looks like, oh no, it's alright, I forgot about the pie throwing thing. Now, those of you who know me will know that I built my own arcade machine. I still haven't done anything with that on my channel, I really should. She is, oh, she's nasty. I forgot how nasty you were. I remember she was hard work. She's kind of cool though, I like her animations, I like the way she's designed generally. No way. Okay, I got to the first level boss. That was that game over. What I was going to say was the arcade version is a bit different. But hey, fair's fair, that was my go. DJ Boy, Sega Mega Drive. Martin, you kicked my bum at that. but hey, I'm having a go at the challenges. I just thought, hopefully this will be the first of many. I'm going to go backwards now and try your Shadow of the Beast 2 challenge, because I really love that game. But more about that on the video for that. DJ Boy Sega Mega Drive, thanks for watching.